Let's start the tutorial of MetaTrader 4 for the mobile versions. I believe every trader on the net do not feel unfamiliar with the new MetaTrader. In fact, it's the most used trading platform in the world. It even had over 10 million downloads already. It's free to download and use MetaTrader 4, nor it has any charges. It is available on Play Store and App Stores. There are two types of MetaTrader, MetaTrader 4 and MetaTrader 5. Most of the users remain using MetaTrader 4, although the MetaTrader 5 has been out for years already. Probably has to do with account registered under MetaTrader 4 are unable to log in to MetaTrader 5, unless registering a new one. Anyway, let's dig into the platform. Stylish, whitish, simple and beautiful. I was attracted to this platform since the beginning of my trading journey. Nah, actually there were limited trading platform available on the market, so learn to stick with it, you're gonna use these for years. At the first launch, you are automatically registered a free demo account by MetaCodes to allow you to access the market, demo-ly. You have to register yourself once since trade is disabled with this free demo account. So on the left side of the screen, we have symbol sets. You're seeing different currency combined. Say the EURUSD known for Euro US dollars with two different price codes. Left is the selling price while right is the buying price. The word spread means the price differences between the buying and selling price. Low means the lowest rate of the day, and high means the highest rate of the day of that certain currency symbols based on the every day's opening hours of Sydney. On the right, we have a chart of the selected symbol set. There are three types of chart available: line, bar, and candlestick. These type of chart are known as the candlestick or the Japanese candlesticks chart. It is popular and are widely used by traders for its non-complexity and clear picture given to trader of the closing and the opening price of each candlestick bar. Chart mode is changeable according to your preference. Just tap on the little gear icon here, line type, and select the one you prefer. The bar chart looks a little bit dominoes to me, if you know what I mean. Then we have the line chart, which looks simple, overly simple. Well, I prefer candlestick chart anyway. Did you see the word M5 here? It means 5 minute time frame per candlestick. Some traders prefer trading with a bigger time frame, while some prefer a smaller one. We can change it by tapping on the chart here. A circle appears with numbers and words. M stands for minutes, while H stands for hours, and D stands for days, then W stands for weeks. You can switch around to get a bigger or smaller picture of the history of the selected currency symbol to determine if this is a buy or sell zone, or just to study the chart. This is an indicator window. RSI stands for Relative Strength Index, momentum type of indicator, used to judge if the market is overbought or oversold. It is not absolute to install only a single indicator, we can actually add more or remove them. To do it, tap on the screen, tap on the F symbol here. We have two options here, adding an indicator to the main chart or blending to the existing indicator window. To give you a clearer view, let's try the second option first. Adding this much of indicator are not recommended anyway. We are not gonna use this much of indicator, let me remove them. Then let's try the first option. Some indicators are added directly to the chart, say moving average. Some indicator has an individual window like the RSI we have saw earlier. Mainly, there are four types of indicators: trend, momentum, volume, and volatility. It is advisable to study their properties and blend them together for a greater result on your trades. At the bottom, we we extend the size of the window a little. We are seeing four names here: balance, credit, equity, and free margin. There are actually two more: margin and margin level. This is your account hit point. Your mission is to secure them from getting to zero, especially as a new trader, unless your account is not funded yet. Balance stands for the amount of money you have deposited plus the profit or losses of all finalized trade. Credits usually stands for bonus, like deposit bonus or welcome bonus offered by your broker. Equity represents the real-time value of your trading account. This number is what you should focus on. Free margin is calculated by equity minus margin, which every trade open requires margin depending on the leverage you have picked. Like this, a portion of your balance was held opposed to the volume of unit you have purchased, known as margin. Free margin is the number after minusing equity. And margin level is the ratio of equity to margin. We will continue this later. Now we got three different tabs here. Trade stands for any open position including pending order. Here is where you manage your trades. History are the record of all closed trade. Journal is the record of all activities you made here, including login, log out, opening trade, close trade, switch TP points with time spent. It's a log. In some cases, you enjoy trading with 10 accounts. To add or switch an account or adding an account from existing broker, tap the little head icon here. Here shows an account which automatically registered by MetaCodes by default, which trades are disabled. And XM demo account I personally register. Depend on your needs. If you're a new trader who are learning, please don't trade based on your luck or push by energy. Get yourself a demo account by tapping open a demo account. Or let's take xm.com as example. Or if you want to be referred under me, you can use my link below. Go to xm.com, click open a withdrawal account. Get all the detail filled. Of course, it's a demo account, we can fill whatever name we want. Then for the trading account detail or trading platform type, select MT4 since we are using MetaTrader 4. Do not pick MT5, as MT4 and MT5 are not interchangeable as mentioned at the beginning of the video. Account types, anyone, doesn't make any differences. Leverage. Leverage are simply used as a risk measurement. The lower, the lesser amount of volume you are allowed to trade, because it requires higher margin. If you have bigger balance, we want to go 1 to 25. If you have smaller balance, we will go 1 to 888. And your account password. Any random password will work. Just a demo account. Click to open a demo account. Confirm your email address. Then you will receive an address with your account number and your server information. Back to MT4 Mobile. Tap login to an existing account. Type the server name you have been provided earlier. Select the server name. Some broker comes with many server names, so make sure you keep the email. Enter your login detail, including the random password you have created earlier. On the left side, we have the mailbox. Usually mail or alert from your broker regarding issue like changes in margin or overnight fees or trading hours. I ignore them because I don't receive them. Then we have the news feed. Depending on your broker, some don't update at all, just ignore them. We have the economy calendar here, which you have to download it separately. I'm not installing extra apps on my phone simply because a lot of data tracking and stuff. But as an alternative, forexfactory.com provides a free economy calendar with good source of information and discussions too. This is a chart room on notification status. When you are a member on MQL forum, which is free, it's good to communicate around. Then the version of MT4, 2001 to 2019, that means their copyright has not been renewed on 2020. Anyway, give them a 5-star rating, they deserve it. Now you're starting to trade, you sweep the screen around for a while and couldn't find the trading instrument you want to trade. For example, crude oil future, but your broker listed that as tradable. Not really, we just have the treasure hunts. The little plus icon here is where all trading instruments that were hidden in the app list. No dragon were guarding anyway. Oh well, let's see if we can find the crude oil future here. Yep. That's how you add a trading instrument. Next, we're gonna do some drawing on the chart like a kid, to flourish and make it alive, as if it's telling us their stories. Tap on the chart, there's these boxes here, you wanna tap it. Tap on the plus, and I'm sad to say I know nothing more than vertical, horizontal, and trend line. Let's try it anyway. Look at my masterpiece, what can you tell from my drawing? Actually, these drawings are meant to find its support and resistance price, known for the bounce or breakout range. Then, if you want to get rid of the drawing, use the dumpster icon to remove them. This is the crosshair. With data window enabled, hover over a specific candle gives us an idea the high, low, and volume of transaction made on that candlestick alone. Pretty cool. Let's start a trade, let's be professional for a while. Take a look at the EURUSD in the 4 hours time frame. We are seeing the resistance level is roughly around here, and the support level is around here. For the past few hours, EURUSD has been showing a bullish sign, but it rocketed out of view. Get the crosshair out and check its total number of transactions. A couple of hours back then, this candlestick was struggling to make upward or downward movement, with a total trading volume of 12762 or $127.62 billion. And the last candle was moving downward with the same trading volume. I have sufficient reason to believe this is moving downward more. But this is a buying zone? Probably not a good entry point. Oh well, just let's start a trade anyway. Tap and hold the symbol set you want to trade, then tap new order. You're given three options. Market executions means live executions. That means your order are handled and executed directly at the current market rate. Buy order means you make a reservation of the price below the current price, see here. When the price is hit, your order is triggered. Sell order is the opposite actually. Buy stop is that you make a reservation of a price above the current price, see it here. When the price is hit, your order is triggered. Sell stop is the opposite too. This number here is the amount of trading size. Depends on your broker, some offer standard lots, while some offer mini lots. It varies between broker, it should be listed on the registration page. Like earlier, we register as a standard count, that means 100,000 units as per standard lot. Saw that? Or in another word, every 1 pips of movement costs $10 in EURUSD. I'm not trying to make it complex, in simple words, keep this number as small as possible. The 2 little box here with numbers of zeros is right for take profit and left for stop loss. For when that certain price is reached, trade is closed in terms of stop or take profit. You can actually leave it blank, otherwise set an appropriate amount and tap sell or buy by market by your choice. We have an opening trade right now, saw the margin and the margin level. Depending on the leverage you picked earlier, the smaller the ratio you have picked, the bigger the margin are required. This is how free margin is calculated, equity minus margin. And margin level? Don't get this number to fall below 50%, otherwise you will get a margin call. All trades will be closed automatically. Let's continue the part we have stopped. So, in case you forgot to set the take profit or stop losses or both, you're allowed to modify your trade later on. Except on weekends during market close time. Not sure why MetaCodes doesn't allow that. By tapping here, you get a trading summary, how much you're profiting or losing. By tapping here, you get to modify the stop loss and take profit. Confirm if you want to close the trade. Confirm. Goodbye, 27 cents. Please be warned, never trade with single-handed. There are times where you mistakenly tap on the wrong button which leads to losing trades, like me. Then the closed trade will be shown on history. And journal the records of your activities. Hope you learn a thing or two. We'll be posting more educational stuff in near futures, like the basics of Forex. Then, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment box.